Hello everybody. Today a look at three knives which are actually in production since a very long time. We are talking here about truly immortal classics. What will I have a look at? Well, the French Douk-Douk, and then two knives made these days by the German Otter company. We're talking about the Mercator knife, which your grandfather perhaps used when he was a young teenager already, and from the same company a kind of a sailor knife with the anchor being laid in. First a look at the Douk-Douk. So the Douk-Douk was originally a design, a cheap and simple design for the developing countries. Actually, in some African countries, Douk-Douk is still a synonym for a knife. So I will open this. The handle is simplicity itself, it's just a piece of folded metal. However, there is a strong spring inside which allows the blade to be really difficult to put back. So it's a slip, kind of a slip joint, but really with a strong spring. You cannot close it with one hand. And so it also stops at 90 degrees, which gives some safety. Which is good, because these things are truly, truly terrifyingly sharp and out of the box. It was one of the sharpest knives I ever got. So you see it says Douk-Douk. This one is actually a carbon steel knife, but they also exist in stainless. Now I think this kind of very classic knife should be carbon steel. This is a bit a fun alternative to an opinel, you could say. Notice here on the handle, well, I have to see with the reflection. Yes, I think now you can see it. There is a kind of a strange man. Well, this is a kind of an African magician, actually, which was there as an illustration. Now, in some countries, from religious reasons, they put other pictures on this instead. Well, I've got here the classic magician little man. So it was really designed as a cheap utility knife. Now actually in the insurrections in Algeria, that was back then a French colony, it seems that this was also very popular as a cheap weapon for assassinations that could easily be thrown away. It didn't cost anything, there were plenty of them. So actually, if I'm not mistaken, they were even forbidden for a while in some of these countries. But so it's still being made because it's a practical, cheap utility knife, and I think especially it has a lot of character, the Douk-Douk. Just the name is nice, the silk stream print is nice. Now I'm a relatively light user of this one because I don't want to hurt the drawing here. I had actually a special edition where the metal here is more shiny than usual, and which comes with a small leather pouch, including even a little iron to sharpen it if should you want to. So yeah, that is I think quite a nice gadget. So it's something fun, something really different from the usual. And so simple simple one piece of metal handle. It's old fashioned design, but it still works very well. And I think if you're into knives, it's something worth discovering. The classic Douk-Douk. It's nothing like it. Well, almost nothing like it. I have actually here something which is a bit like it. Even older than the Douk-Douk is here the Mercator knife. This is a bigger one in stainless steel, but typically they were in carbon steel, also called the cat knife, and the exact type is K55K, with here a panther. They also exist without that picture, but I mean, you need it with the classic picture. And indeed, this kind of knife was made in Germany and used, well, definitely in Europe quite a lot, but a bit everywhere around the world as a cheap pocket knife since roughly the First World War. So this is a classic design. Well, it's also still practical. It's a neutral kind of utility blade. So you see, it's nothing fancy. We are not talking tanto points or recurves. It's beautifully sharp. It's also a very, very strong backlock. It's really an absolute pain to press it enough to, so that it closes. So in that sense, it's very dependable. So simple, and a bit with the metal, simple sheet of metal handle, in that context is a bit similar to the Opinel. I like both, I must say. Perhaps the German Mercator knife even a bit more, because it's a bit lighter. Yeah, and I think that the blade shape is perfectly neutral and practical, and and a timeless classic, I think. So again, a non-tactical, very, very classic utility knife. Very different from also both of them are. Well, just as classic as, let's say, a case knife or a German sleeper knife, they are very different, actually. Different timeless approach. And then, briefly, this one. Company Otter Messer in Solingen, handmade, kind of a sailor knife, you could say. So I open it. This is a carbon steel one. It's possible that they also exist in stainless, but I'm not certain. Pretty nice in the hand, very classical, with a brass inlay of the anchor. It's an inlay, it's not a print. The particular knife shape, it allows for pulling cuts, which can be handy when there is a rope, so that the rope, think of when you're on a ship, doesn't slip away. That's why these days some knives have this more beak-like form. Some knives which are designed for to be used on ships, which is actually even better than this. But otherwise, quite universal, and I think it's simply charming. It's truly old-fashioned. You could have guessed that I bought this somewhere in an antiquary market, but no. This is straight from the manufacturer, very cheap, the price of a CD, and really handmade. Now, what you have with these knives of Otter, because I've got one more even, the finish isn't absolutely perfect. I had to oil the slip joint a bit, because it felt a bit gritty, actually. It felt, and also, well, the blade could have been a bit better centered, but, well, still, even so, I think it has a lot of character. It's a fun pocket knife, traditional, not aggressive at all, yes, with history. So, I hope you find this an amusing or interesting overview. Let's see, which one is the nicest of the three? Well, I already said it, actually. I mentioned it, they have older character, but for me, I have a slight preference for the Mercator knife. It's light and compact, and it's quite with a strong backlog. That is quite a fun one. Well, I hope you found this another interesting review. I still have a few more to do with knives for my small collection. So feel free to leave your bluntly honest feedback.